You're asked to simplify this. Now, don't let the large numbers intimidate you. It's very much easier to simplify with the prime factorization here of 108. Okay, so I went off to the side, and 108 is 2 squared times 3 to the third times x to the fourth. Once you have the prime factors, it really is easy to work with. Minus 3x times the cubed root. Now, off to the side, 864 I found is 2 to the fifth times 3 to the third. Well, times that x. Okay, so off the side I found the prime factorizations. Now you go ahead and find the cubed roots. 2 times. Now, for this first cubed root, 2 squared is not enough, but we do have 3 to the third. So the cubed root of 3 to the third here is 3. And it looks like I can think of x to the fourth as x cubed times x, or 3 goes into 4 one time, so I could take an x out. And what's going to be left inside that cubed root is 2 squared times one of those x's. 3 goes into 4 one time with a remainder of 1. Minus 3x. 3 goes into 5, the exponent of the base 2, one time. So I can pull a 2 out, and what's going to be left in there is a 2 squared, right? 3 goes into 5 one time with 2 left over. Cubed root of 3 cubed is just 3, so times 3. And then I have that x inside. Okay, let's simplify. So this leaves me with x, 6x cubed root of 4x minus 3 times 2 is 6 times 3 is 18x times the cubed root of 4x. Okay, so now I have like terms. Look at that, these are exactly the same. The variable part here is exactly the same. So 6 minus 18 is negative 12 x cubed root of 4x.